So now we have the piece that started my infatuation with Margaret Sutherland, and I get to introduce the man that was responsible for that, Ben Opie, on your blade. Ben was well aware of Margaret's brilliance long before me, and so I really have him to thank for the support and just the validation that she is a magnificent composer. So, Ben, there aren't many works written for cor anglais, let alone cor anglais in a chamber music setting.
No, that's right. I mean, this is it's really interesting that she chose the cor anglais to be represented in this setting, I think. Yeah.
And because there were some people at the 2 p.m. concert that would like a little bit of an explanation just about the cor anglais and its difference to the oboe.
Of course. So this is kind of like the uncle of the oboe. It's a little bit bigger, and therefore everything's just a little bit deeper. So the nice thing is that all of the fingerings are the same as the oboe, but you can hear it just has a slightly deeper tone. And you might recognize it, probably the most famous is from Dvořák's Ninth Symphony. You know the one. We're not here to play Dvořák today, but it's a fascinating one and a very interesting and unique tone, I think, and colour for this setting.
So this piece is in three movements: the traditional fast, slow, fast. Again, you will hear her unique musical language, her sharp wit. She must have been scintillating conversation. It must have been scintillating conversation with her around the dinner table. It's her quartet for cor anglais and string trio.
Thank you. Thank you.